laptop is in the car, but the iPad is standard operational equipment. Of course, the phone, the smartphone, it sometimes makes me look dumb. So I always keep my notepad so I can scratch. And then, of course, you need a good pen, a good writing pen, because I'm from old school. I want to make sure that I'm able to take some notes. You know, it's quite interesting. This has been a dream come true, being president of the California Association of Realtors. It is something that actually hit me when I first went to C.A.R. When I first started going to the C.A.R. meetings, I think my first meeting, although Mom had me going to meetings earlier, I can remember beginning to go to the meetings on a consistent basis around 92. So almost 20 years for the dream to come to fruition. But it's quite interesting that when you look at those 20 years, it doesn't seem that long. But in terms of your age, it seems a long time. Because y'all was 39 years old back then. Just about to turn 40 at the end. And 20 years later, I'm telling my age. So you see the gray, and so, yeah, I'm 59 years old. I'll be 60 in November. Wow. And it's been a great run. I've been a broker since 1976. I'm a second generation realtor. My son is a third generation realtor. Wow. I've met many second and third generation realtors along the way. It was quite interesting though that my son had a difficult time getting a good job. But now he's having an absolute blast in the real estate business. So maybe you use this trick that my mother used on me. She said, I was playing football in the National Football League. What a dream. Right here, we'd come down to Los Angeles when I was 18 years old, and we beat the USC Trojans, the first Oregon Duck team to come into the Coliseum. The first Oregon Duck team to come into the Coliseum and beat the USC Trojans. Well, we beat them again. We beat them since then. But that was a memorable one. And it was interesting that one of the coaches, in fact, the offensive coordinator for the Ducks that won that game, was John Robinson. And John Robinson later became a great USC coach. And not the last coach, but he lost his job after Oregon came back into the Coliseum about 15, 20 years later and beat the Trojans again. And I think that was John Robinson's last year coaching the USC Trojans. So it was sort of interesting that he beat them, and then he went there and then he lost them, and then it was over. So I just shared a little trivia history for those of you that kind of think back about that. But I think the Ducks have been beating the Trojans pretty regularly these last, but I better get off that subject. But it's this great football. It's great. It was great to play. We were in the old pack of Pacific 8 Conference. It was Stanford and Cal in the central part of the state. There was Oregon and Oregon State up in Oregon. There was Washington and Washington State. And then there was USC and UCLA down here. And that was the Pac-8 back in the day. They've since added, then later they added Arizona State. So it's pretty much been a West Coast kind of operation. But you love the camaraderie. We still talk. I still talk to some of my old boys that I played at school up in Oregon. I still talk to my old friends. In fact, one of the guys is interesting. I was playing for the Denver Broncos at the time. I think Denver had released me, and then I'd gone to try to play with the Dallas Cowboys. And I already had my real estate license because Mom said, get your license just in case. That's for your kid, wherever they are. And they say, well, Mom, I don't know. Or Dad, I don't know if I want to be in real estate. You say, well, why don't you just get your license just in case? And once they get that license, it's like getting a fish on the hook. You're caught. I mean, when you get a good hook in the mouth, especially when you swallow the hook, line, and sinker, you are stuck. And so after now 36 years, 37 years, I got licensed in 75. I became a broker in 77. So now after 35 years of being a broker, what else can I do? Well, quite frankly, I find that brokers do different things. They own companies a lot of times. They're out there competing, right, with their affiliates in some instances. Many of our brokers own mortgage companies, own escrow companies, own home inspection companies. So it's an industry that you're involved with. Some of them go outside of it. Some of them are involved in other items as well. And then they come into real estate and they do the double flip. I've met some TI people that do real estate and they do TI. And so I think the whole idea was, as this is a profession, and I really love it. I mean, I've sold houses and I'm selling houses and I'm making most of my money today from my residential real estate company, Excellence Realty. That's where we're doing most of our business at, that LeFrancis Arnold is doing most of his business with Excellence Realty. And it's interesting that if you're doing real estate today, you probably have an area of specialist or specialty that you work. Many brokers work the residential real estate resale market. In fact, Joe Singer says that's where we are the most effective as an organization, is we do a lot of residential resale business. And in that business today, there are many brokers that are doing REOs or foreclosures, but those numbers are down substantially. And if you read the LA Times this morning, it's down 29% from last year. So the REO business is down substantially, but the short sale business is up tremendously. So, but in that short sale arena, and I have to share this with you, you don't want convoluted messages about what's going on in the short sale market. So when you look at what's going on with the AG, the Attorney General settlement with the five major banks, of some $26 billion, you as a homeowner get a little confused. And so just 2 days ago, I had to think about this, because last week I was at Half Moon Bay in the Bay Area. We had a leadership meeting and we were talking about C.A.R. business from the top with the vice presidents. And then Monday, I came home Saturday, and on Monday I was back on the road headed to Bakersfield for a news conference on Tuesday morning talking about fraud and what's going on in this fraud arena, where people are calling you and knocking on your door and sometimes even saying that they're a part of the settlement, the AG settlement, and we can help you to save your home, or we can help you to have principal reduction, we can do your loan modification, just give me $2,000 cash. Wrong message. We are informing our customers. In fact, there was a public service announcement that C.A.R. has that's in three languages. It's in Mandarin, it's in Spanish, and it's in English, and I believe it's in another Chinese language, I'm not sure. Pardon me?
Cantonese.
Probably. I just don't remember. But I know there were four tapings. I know Alan Chang was there doing it in the Mandarin. I think I forgot who else was there doing it in the Cantonese or the second language from China. And so we were sending a message to our people that if it sounds too good to be true, it probably is. So we want the public to be aware. So these are public announcements that are going out telling people to beware of the scammers, trying to maybe have you transfer your title or give them $2,000 cash up front. The one thing that I tell all of my clients, anyone that asks me, I said, never stop talking to the bank.
continue to talk to your banker, because they even know who's on the list from the AG report and who qualifies for some of this money. Now, lack of that, maybe you go out and get an attorney. But past that, use your trusted advisor, your real estate broker. Use your friend, your real estate agent, and let them advise you, but never stop talking to your banker. Share something else with you. Part of this came out of what the Ventura Association of Realtors is doing, and what they've worked with their local district attorney's office. They have this working group called REFAT. And what they're doing is meeting weekly, monthly. In fact, Jim Keith called me. He's our risk management chair from C.A.R. And he called me, and I got to probably call him back today. And they've been the model, the role model for this real estate fraud task force. And they're funding this task force with local money from the Ventura County, and they are actually realtors and people on this committee are self-policing. They're blowing the whistle on those people out there creating fraud. The brokers have to step up. And when you have an agent that's doing fraud, you have to report it. And so we're getting vehicles there so we can continue to stop this, the scams and the schemes that are perpetrated upon our customers. So this, you want to just be aware of this. You want to understand it. I am a working broker to that extent. In fact, it's interesting, I was been home the last 3 days, even though I went to Bakersfield, you know, we were home that morning. No, actually, I went there Monday night, so I missed all Tuesday, and then back to work on Wednesday, and I'm going to work today, and then I'm going to work tomorrow morning a little bit, and then I'm on my way to Vegas, and then I'm on my way to China. So that was an experience. And somebody said, why did you pay somebody to get your passport? I said, you know what, I wanted to experience that myself. So you go down to the veteran, to the office down 11,000 Wilshire, and then you get your passport, and then you got to go to China to the consulate over on Chateau, which is right around the corner, about a block and a half from the C.A.R. building. The C.A.R. building is at 525 Virgil Avenue. And I think the consulate is at 501 where you get your passport, 501 Chateau, which is two blocks away. So it's really interesting, and then the phenomena of being able to now go to China and as the president, right? I got some on my for the side. So as president, I called Joe Singer. I said, Joe, I'm going to China. I said, what do you want me to talk about? How do you want me to present CR's position when I go to China? We sit down here with these millionaires, billionaires, business people, and find out what, you know, tell them about California real estate. And so he said, oh, you need to talk to Oscar. Let him put together a presentation for you. So he and Sarah. And Sarah is one of our economists, and they'll put this proposal together for us. So I got a beautiful PowerPoint presentation from CAR. And then they also want me to do a thing on the broker role. And so I had them send me a piece on the broker role, but I said, well, I'll do a better job myself on the broker role because I know what I want to tell them we can do for them. Meaning you, me, and our brokerage industry in California. So it's exciting. And then when you begin to read what's going on, the foreign dollars are beginning to come into California. In fact, I saw an article where there's Chinese money coming right here in the West San Gabriel Valley area and the San Gabriel Valley area. So I'm hearing this and I'm saying, oh, that's good information. That's good news. So part of the PowerPoint presentation shows some big projects. Boy, by the way, the Coliseum, the convention center next to the Staples Center. There's a proposal for a new football stadium out there. So we'll be talking a little bit about that. You know, but it's exciting to, and I share with you, I was in just 2 days ago, I was in Bakersfield talking about this problem. Well, I was in San Diego a couple of weeks ago talking about it. I was in Sacramento after our CAR meetings last month. Yeah, last month I was in Sacramento doing the same thing. And we were on ABC News. And so we're trying to get this out to the general public. What's going on in the real estate industry right now? Literally, what the brokers are saying, and we have met with the leaders in the industry, the brokers. We've met with them both in Southern California and Northern California. And the fear that I'm hearing from them is inventory. That the amount of inventory that we have for sale is low, and we're getting multiple offers. And so, is there a seller's market? Well, not quite, because if you're financing it, the appraisers have something to say about what the value is. So if everybody had cash, we'd probably be in a seller's market today, but we aren't. Everybody doesn't have cash. Flip that house has cash, you know, and so for some of your short sales and some of your REOs, they're gonna be trying to get those from. And so that will continue and has spared the economy, but there's been an increase in the number of sales for the $300,000 plus range. So the middle upscale market is beginning to develop itself, and I believe it was a 21% increase in sales month over month. I think I read that in the LA Times this morning. But I haven't gotten my C.A.R. report, and I respect C.A.R.'s report, Leslie Appleton Young's report, because they get it from the multiple listed information, and the multiple listed information is probably as accurate as you can get. Although everything doesn't sell on a multiple listed, doesn't. I mean, we understand that being the book reporter. But you know, the thing is, and I really want to share this with you, and I kind of need something in my hand, because I just want something in my hand as I kind of go around. I want it to break out. You can hear me?
Yes.
Okay, great. You know, it's this being the president, it's quite interesting. You really learn about this organization. You, as the top man in this organization, is Kevin Brown from Oakland. And so if you want a position next year, you need to get to Kevin Brown, you need to get to Chris Kutsky, or you need to get to Don Fong and ask them to promote you into a leadership position. You don't even need a letter from me. In fact, you may not want a letter from me, because I'm just who I am. I'm LeFrancis Arnold. I'm this year's president, number two last year. Next year I'll be out. Well, you know, it's just real. Let's be real. I'm out. And I ran twice. The first time I ran was, I think I started my campaign in 02. I started my first campaign in 02. Okay, and then one of the guys who helped me to run, he died in 04, just before my election. And so I lost my presidential support. So I said, if you're ever gonna run for CR president, you have to have some past president support. So what I did this time when I ran is I went to all the past presidents and I said, would you support me for president of the California Association of Realtors? And so we started getting more and more, and we got two or three. We got Dick Gaylord to take the, Diana Bull finally said yes, and she run my campaign. Well, by the time I did that, it was over. I had it. I just had to go out there, and so I was up and down the state. This is my second time around, the second day. I'm up and down the state. I'm up in Aaron called Susanville. I'm up in Humboldt County. I'm down in Calexico. I'm down in San Diego. I'm all on the coast. I'm in Barstow. I'm up to 5. I'm up to 99. And literally from this time being the president and doing my president visits and running for president, I think I've been to all 114 associations. Not quite, it's the season. But I've been here more than once. I mean, I've been in this room. In fact, I was talking about it because the last three times I came to San Gabriel Valley, I was at the hotel, your installation, I think I was at Kerpa's installation, and then somewhere else. And then Kerpa had me over here. Oh, we did a diversity thing. Now, CR does, every year, does this thing on diversity. I think it's great because we meet with area, NARAB, NARAB, Kerpa. We all meet and we talk about the political issues for CR. And that's where I want to go now. I want to talk a little bit about the political issues. You know, how much time do I have? I'm having so much fun. I mean, I'm kind of going to share with you about how this works, because we need to get another president from, you know, somewhere down in Southern California.
We've never had one from this association.
I know, and I was our first in Rancho.
I was the first. Now, we had one, Hogue. And does anybody know who Hogue is? I think he's...
Horsley Olsen. Horsley
Olsen? No, Hogue. Hogue was from Downey.
Yeah, from Downey.
Yeah, and he's still kind of... You know, his name is still out there. I don't know if he's alive or not, but he was president back in the 60s. Okay, so I mean, that was a long time ago. But first, the thing is Rancho from Rancho Southeast is I'm our first president. I was our first NAR director in 20 years because we didn't have the 2,000 members. You have to have 2,000 members. And so sometimes it's disproportionate. So I was kind of sharing with you how this system works. And there's 159,000, we ended up with 159,000 members in 2011. We're supposed to have 155. No, I take that back. We have 159,000 members now. And that's up from 155 projected. And so next year, the projection is about 152,000 members. So our membership is beginning to stable off. There were 114 associations across the state. All of them don't have AEs, but all of the big ones do. All of the medium-sized have leadership at the AE position. Some of the real smaller ones. You have some associations as small as 100 people, less than 100 people. So you do have some smaller associations across the state. The system works something like this. You have 32 regions in the state. 1 through 33, and I think 26 doesn't exist. 26 merged with another region. So you have 31 regions. And on nominating, you have 35 members of nominating. There's the past president, there's an ex officio, and then there's a third party that gets selected. So there's 35 people on the nominating committee. And that 35 people select your president and your treasurer. So who's your nominated member this year? Who's
the father?
Who?
My father.
Oh, see there? Okay, there's a second generation realtor right
there.
Third.
See what I'm saying?
Yeah.
You got second and third generation. And you know, interesting, this organization started that's your boy? But you know, we love this business. I tell you, being your president has just given one great tribute. I love it, I love it, I love it. And I don't know if I could do it again, because I know I can't. So my goal and objective this year is just to be the best C.A.R. president that I can be. I'm not trying to set any records, although they tell me I'm doing more meetings than in contact with the members like no president has been in several years. But I think Steve Goddard was pretty busy. I know he was going as often as I could recall president going now. Beth did not go as often. And typically what happens is this. Let me just share this with you. When you're the treasurer, and you ascend from treasurer to president, you're there, your treasurer, actually your treasurer-elect, just for a hot second, and then your treasurer for 2 years, and then your president-elect, and then your president. So it's a 4+ year commitment when you're the treasurer. Whereas the president-elect comes in now in May as the president-elect, and then he's on a fast track to find out real quick that in November he'll be the president-elect. And then he'll be the president-elect for a year, and then that next November he becomes a president, and at that next November he's nobody. But it's the whole point is for that 1 year, you're the chairman of you're the chairman in California of the largest state organization in the country. I want to give you a little bit more history. I want you to kind of know about this organization. We have about 800 directors for the California Association of Realtors. There's probably about 900 that we could have if everybody maxed out their CR directors, but it's hard to fund all of them. And then, of course, some of them have to fund themselves.
And so there's an issue there. So we have 800 or so C.A.R. directors. There's about 900 or so N.A.R. directors. So that number is reduced. But out of the 900 N.A.R. directors or so, California has about 109. Well, there's only about a million, it's just a little under 1.1 million, between a million and 1.1 million realtors across the country. But we have 159,000 realtors. So when you look at the numbers, we represent almost 16% of the realtors countrywide. And why is that? Well, there's some reasons why, but one of them, I think we run a great, close organization. We didn't necessarily want to get into the MLS business, but we are, and we're doing a real good job of it. The merger that the merger you helped us get with MRMLS, see, it's a team effort. No matter how you look at this, and I learned that at a young age, that team becomes so important to your success. And so and when you look at this whole dynamics of C.A.R., and when you look at who we are and what we represent, we actually represent a political base. Even though we're business orientated, we are held together, and NAR is talking about it particularly, is that we're an advocacy group. When you look at the state countrywide, the countrywide, we are an advocacy group, and our biggest strength is our political. And so I can talk to this group about it because I look at you more as a leadership in this area. And that is, you know, putting up the dollars. Is this the right one? I'm touching it? Yeah. Not the president, not being president of the association or president of the state or president of the country, but putting up the dollars. I mean, this is my renewal for my California Golden R. And so the California Golden R has been shifted to the Silver Bear. It costs $1,000 to invest in the Silver Bear. And each of you should be a Silver Bear, at least. Well, I know we talk about $197 is the true cost of doing business. And so yeah, if that's all you can afford today, okay, everyone was assessed the $49. I'm not talking to the affiliates on this one. I'm talking, although you could become a Golden R2 affiliate too, if you thought that you had that kind of resource that you wanted to invest with the Realtor organization. But the Golden, the Silver Bear is the $1,000. The President's Circle is $2,000. And the NAR Golden R is $5,000. And it's annual. I think the annual fee for the Golden R for NAR, I think, is $1,500. But the President's Circle is annual, it's $2,000. But everyone should at least pay the $197, which you've all been assessed to $49. That goes, we did that a couple years ago where everybody had to pay at least the $49. And on the political side, we end up probably close with a budget of $11 million. And that means we could fund every congressional member, there are 53 congressional representatives, from the state of California to the United States Congress, which has 453 or 553 members of the Congress. I think it's 453 members, of which we have 53 members. So we've got the numbers, and we typically can get legislation through at the congressional level, but we only have two senators. And every other state in the union has two senators. So our politics have to make sense, both at NAR and here at C.A.R. And we do need the money. I mean, believe me, on the political side, do you know that we just went through a change in our assemblymen and our state representatives? We just changed again how long they could be in office. Do you know that? That we just voted for that? We just voted for it. And that they reduced the amount of years from 14 to 12, but you can now serve all 12 years in one house. That's a big change. It used to be that you can do 6 in the Assembly and 8 in the Senate. Now you can do all 12 in the Senate or Assembly. So the politics have changed again. So we, your LCRCs, who's on LCRC? Who's on the LCRC committee? Anybody in the room on LCRC? You got a couple LCRC members in here? Okay. And your job, LCRCs, is to help C.A.R. I mean, if there's a politician that's running an assembly or senate that affects this area, and let's say your neighbors to the east, you need, with Citrus Valley, you need to both do the interviews together. And you need to send a recommendation to see, to CREPAC. CREPAC may look at the polling and say you're crazy. How could you want to support this guy and he has no support? We've done, is there any polling? Okay, maybe that you can get him down. Okay, well, why don't we do some, pay somebody to do some polling? And that could be, could allow it to be more objective. So these are ways that you can begin to control the politics. We were talking in this room a minute ago with the housing committee about controlling the politics of your cities. Redevelopment is gone. But that doesn't mean eminent domain is gone. There still could be planning for housing and housing development. There's ways for us to work together. And see, that is the part, work together. Teamwork, teamwork, teamwork. That's why I talk about fair share, putting up your money. Put the dollars on the table, a minimum of the 197, and then step it up when you can. And then we talk about controlling our cities and the LCRCs and networking and this whole nine yards. But I can tell you one thing, I am so proud of this organization. You've supported me the entire way. I got support when I ran the first time from this group. I didn't win, and that's okay, because you felt so good about that process. In fact, a guy by the name of Vince Malter is the one who beat me. And Vince asked me to walk into the room with him that Saturday morning when he walked in to celebrate his victory, and I walked in with him hand in hand. And it showed people something, because it was at that time there had not been another minority who had been elected president of the California Association of Realtors. But I want to share with you that since then there were, has been three. And people say, oh, three. I thought Bill Brown was the first. No, Bill Brown was not the first diverse person to be president of the California Association of Realtors. It was a half Hispanic woman. And Colleen was Dr. Acker. What's she name? Dr. Acker, man. Okay, that was her marriage. That's her marriage name. And Colleen's mother was Hispanic. And so the first minority to be president of the California Association of Realtors in 2007, I believe it was Colleen Badakwe. And so I'm so proud to be your president, and I want to just give you a moment to ask me a question or two. My mind is full, but when you are the president, you get briefed on all kind of information. You get emails, you get, and you read, and you study, and I'm on a pad for a couple of packs for NAR, so now I'm going from C.A.R. leadership to NAR, and I'm very proud to do that. So I want to take a question. Any question that you have?